बंसी के अंदर डायग्राम इनग्वाइनल लिगामेंट सी दिस इज योर एंटीरियर सुपीरियर इलेक स्पाइन दिस इज योर इनग्वाइनल लिगामेंट दिस रेड वन विच आई एम हाईलाइटिंग दिस इज योर इनग्वाइनल लिगामेंट नाउ दिस येलो वन विच आई एम हाईलाइटिंग नाउ येलो वन दिस इज विच लिगामेंट
लैक्यूनर लिगामेंट
लैक्यूनर लिगामेंट राइट दिस इज विच लिगामेंट लैक्यूनर लिगामेंट एंड नाउ दिस लिगामेंट विच आई एम हाईलाइटिंग नाउ इन ब्लैक सी दिस लिगामेंट इज नोन एज व्हाट पेक्टिनियल लिगामेंट इज इट नोन एज विच लिगामेंट
पेक्टिनियल लिगामेंट
पेक्टिनियल लिगामेंट सी नाउ सी हियर A ring is forming here. What is the name of this ring? See here, everyone. This is the ring. Okay. This ring, which is forming here anteriorly by the red one, our inguinal ligament, then medially the lacunar ligament, and then posteriorly the pectineal ligament. This ring is known as femoral ring. This is known as which ring?
Femoral
ring. Okay, so see here. Femoral ring, if anyone is going to ask you the boundaries of the femoral ring, your answer will be very simple. Anteriorly, it is forming by this red ligament, that is your inguinal ligament. Posteriorly, it is forming by this black color ligament that is known as the pectineal ligament. Medially, it is forming by this yellow ligament known as the lacunar ligament. Which ligament? Lacunar ligament. And now this is the femoral ring. But this femoral ring also must have some lateral boundary, right? So see here. Lateral boundary is formed by this structure. I draw it in blue color, but it is passing under the inguinal ligament. Okay. Just for the diagram, I am telling you, this is your, because I draw it in blue color, this is your femoral vein. So please remember femoral vein. It is forming the lateral boundary of your femoral ring. It is clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Once again, I am explaining to all of you. Femoral ring. Number one, you have inguinal ligament, which is shown here in the red color. Then you have lacunar ligament. This is shown in the yellow color here. And then you have the posterior extension of the inguinal ligament, which is shown here in the black color. That is your pectineal ligament. And in between these three ligaments, the ring is forming, that is known as the femoral ring. Okay. And the femoral ring lateral boundary, the lateral boundary of the femoral ring, it is formed by the femoral vein. Formed by which structure?
Femoral
vein. Now see here another thing. Here an artery is also passing. See? This artery is known as which artery? This is your femoral artery. Okay? It is external iliac artery, but when it passes through the inguinal ligament, now it becomes which artery? Femoral artery. Okay. And then you have a nerve is also present here. Okay. This nerve is known as femoral nerve. This is known as which nerve?
Femoral nerve.
Now, very important point, which I am telling to you all of. Please listen very carefully. Your femoral artery your femoral vein. Both are present in a sheet, and that sheet is known as femoral sheet. That is known as which sheet?
Femoral sheet.
So please remember, femoral sheet. Contents of your femoral sheet will be, it will be your femoral vein, it will be your femoral artery, but it is not your femoral nerve. Femoral nerve is not present in the femoral sheet. Okay, your femoral nerve, it is present outside the femoral sheet. It is present outside the femoral sheet. Now see here, what is now femoral hernia? If the hernia, now I'm trying to draw it in black. This is which ring? Femoral ring. If the intestinal contents passing through this femoral ring, and now it enters into your thigh region, okay? So this is your, you can say this is your femoral hernia. Which hernia?
Femoral hernia.
So sometimes what happens, please remember, here lymphatics are also present. So sometimes what happens that the intestines can follow the lymphatics and they can enter into this femoral ring. And they, when it enter into this femoral ring, it will bulges out here. And when it bulges out here, it results in a hernia that is known as femoral hernia. That is known as which hernia?
Femoral hernia.
Now see here, this femoral hernia, it is going to become strangulated because here you have femoral sheet, which is covering femoral artery, femoral vein, okay? And here you have the lacunar ligament. So if I want to make or enlarge the femoral ring, I will try to make an incision in your lacunar ligament, okay? So if I want to release the pressure, from this femoral ring, because intestines are obstructed there, I will make an incision on the lacunar ligament and I will try to enlarge the femoral ring so that it will release the pressure of the femoral hernia. Okay? But sometimes what happens in this lacunar ligament, sometimes a branch of your inferior epigastric artery is present, and that branch is known as accessory obturator artery. Which artery?
Accessory obturator artery.
So please remember, when surgeons in some population, an accessory obturator artery is present in this lacunar ligament, and when you are going or it is running through this lacunar ligament, so when they are trying to cut, because they have to release the pressure from the intestines, because the intestines are strangulating here, their blood pressure is compromising. So we can make an incision to this lacunar ligament, but we must be very careful, because in some percentage or some population, an accessory obturator artery, it is running in this lacunar ligament. Okay, so this is a very important point which you must have to remember. Okay, it is clear to everyone?
Yes,